So, our today's topic is Obadi Fajari. The last class of the OSP, this is the Obadi Fajari. So, now we are going to discuss some common Obadi Fajari that is important for your exam. First of all, this is the appendectomy. The most commonly done surgical procedure in every government hospital is the appendectomy. So, this is the commonly common emergency surgery, appendectomy. So first of all, what are the incision for what are the indication for appendectomy? Hello?
Acute appendicitis.
Yes. So most common is the acute appendicitis. And maybe due to recurrent appendicitis, and some other case like neoplastic dehiscence in case of carcinoid tumor of appendix that involves the tip of the appendix, and in some cases the mucosal of appendix. So most commonly is the acute appendicitis, and in some case recurrent appendicitis, or and carcinoid tumor that involves the tip of the appendix. Clear?
Sir, to interrupt, sir.
Yes.
Sir, aro koyekjon sir chat e janiyeche ajke niye neowar jonno. Tahole sir ajke 9ta theke 10ta niye nite paren sir.
Acha, amra shesh kore eta pore amra ashbo, ha?
Okay, sir.
So, the most important appendectomy. So, these are the indication. So, what are the indication?
Sir, acute appendicitis. Sir, carcinoid tumor in the tip of the appendix or mucosal of appendix.
And in some cases, recurrent appendicitis also. If it is in the answer question in the OSP exam, so these are the you must write this. Okay, for so these are the indication. So next, what are incision?
Gridiron incision.
Bolo.
Gridiron incision, sir.
Then,
sir, Rutherford Morrison incision. Gridiron incision ke extend kore Rutherford Morrison incision e convert kora jete pare. Lange incision e kora jete pare.
So, most important gridiron incision. Then.
Rutherford Morrison incision, Lange incision, and right lower paramedian incision.
So you just hold for few seconds. Just hold. I am okay. So gridiron incision. Then so these are the incision. So most commonly done. These are the incision. This is called. Gridiron incision for appendicitis. It is an incision center on the McManus point. There is the, so what is McManus point? What is the exact? Bolo.
Umbilicus, sir, right one, means little 1/3 J pointer.
So it is the point between the umbilicus and anterior cervical spine, lateral 1/3 and medial, at the junction of lateral 1/3 and medial 2/3. Okay. So this is the McManus point. So this is the oblique incision at right angle to the McManus point. So this is the gridiron incision. So next important is the this is called. This is Lange incision. This one is the Lange incision. It is easily cosmetic incision. Cosmetic. Easily Lange incision for cosmetic purpose. But just hold for a few seconds. Yeah, done. হ্যাঁ ওই যে ওরা বলতেছে আজকে নিয়ে যান লং কেস, আমি মিনিমাম ইমো নাকি ওরা বলতে যাচ্ছে যে ওভারসাইজের পরে। হ্যাঁ না ওরা ওরা বলতেছে, ওরা বলতেছে স্যার এ করেন এটা শেষ করে এক ঘন্টা আপনি লং কেস নিয়ে নেবেন। আচ্ছা হ্যাঁ আচ্ছা না অসুবিধা নেই, তাহলে তোমায় জানাচ্ছি আর কি, ঠিক আছে। আচ্ছা ওকে থ্যাংক ইউ। So when we use buffer Rutherford Morrison incision, Rutherford incision, when we give Rutherford Morrison incision?
It's a good exposure, John. No, sir.
Okay, if appendix cannot be visualized, if appendix is retrocecal, is there a gross adhesion? In that case, we extend the incision by, it is called muscle cutting. Muscle cutting rather for Morrison incision. Muscle cutting incision. Normally in appendicectomy, we just split the external oblique and transverse abdominal muscle. Internal oblique and transverse abdominal muscle. But in case of rather for Morrison incision, we can cut the internal oblique as well as transverse abdominal muscle for exposure and in case of retrocecal appendix or in case of appendix subhepatic cavity, retrocecal subhepatic type of appendix, or if there is gross adhesion. In that case, we can go for Rutherford Morrison incision. So, what are the steps of appendicectomy? Either Lange incision or Guidard incision.
Sir, normally, kon muscle cut
Normally, we just split the muscle. No need for cutting the muscle. But in case of Rutherford Morrison incision, we cut the internal oblique and transverse abdominal muscle. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So, either Guillain incision or Lange incision, first of all, we give the skin incision, either horizontal or oblique skin incision. Then we cut the subcutaneous tissue, as well as superficial fat layer and deep membranous layer in the same line of incision. Then we split the external oblique epinephysis in the line of incision. Then we incise the external oblique in the line of incision. Then we expose the internal oblique and transverse abdominal muscle and split the internal oblique and transverse abdominal muscle and then open the peritoneum and then identify the appendix. After opening the peritoneal cavity and enlargement of the peritoneal incision, we can identify the appendix. So how can you identify the appendix during surgery? Why? How can you identify the appendix during surgery?
Worm-like structure, dekho.
Okay, this is the worm-like structure. We can follow the tenia coli. Okay. We can follow the tenia coli. As tenia coli ends at the lower end of cecum and easily, where tenia coli ends, there is a ileocecal bulb junction and cecum, and we see that in that area we can look for appendix. It is a walnut structure. And after finding the appendix, we grasp the appendix with Becko forceps and then ligate the mesoappendix. And then we grasp the base of appendix and ultimately cut the appendix between the ligature and hemostatic forceps. So these are the OF appendicectomy. And then after that, we close the field by four layer. Peritoneum closure, muscle closure, shoulder of extraordinary appendicitis and then skin closure. So these are the steps of appendicitis. So now, what are the complications of appendicitis? What are the complications of appendicitis? What are the complications of appendicitis? Bolo.
Injury, accidental injury to the bowel or vessels.
Yes.
So, bleeding, bowel perforation, peritonitis, and slipping of ligature.
Yes, yes, very good.
Fistula formation.
Formation of fistula. This is all about, but if you say like this, operation complication during surgery and after surgery. Early completion and so during surgery, there may be injured the bowel like cecum, tamina ileum, injured the female, injured the fallopian tube. If you wrongly identify fallopian tube, you may injure the fallopian tube or in some case ovary. And then if active kidney, you can injure the kidney, active kidney. So injured the surrounding structure. During surgery and after surgery, there may be bleeding. If you like it, then the appendix loosely, or so it cannot like it, then the appendix properly, so there is bleeding. Huge bleeding from the appendix. So these are the during surgery and after surgery, there may be own infection, hemorrhage, intraabdominal abscess, fecal fistula, and late ileus. So these are the complications of appendicitis. So now I put a question to the student. So if during surgery, if you found appendix is normal, so what to do? During surgery, you see the appendix is normal. So what you look for?
Sir, we will do appendicitis.
No. Is you can go for appendicitis, you can suspect there is appendicitis, but during surgery, you see there is appendicitis normal, no inflammation. So what can you do? Could you search anything other than appendix? Yes, there may be other pathology like. It may be to Meckel's diverticulum at least. So you can look for Meckel's diverticulum. You can see a tamina ileum also, tamina ileum. You can look also for tamina ileum to see any enteritis. This is called inflammatory bowel disease. So if appendix is normal, healthy, in that case, you can look up for tamina ileum for inflammatory bowel disease, Meckel's diverticulum, also for Meckel's diverticulum. In case of female, you can look for fallopian tube, right fallopian tube and right ovary. Clear? So is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
So these are the this is all about appendicitis. So next important is the cholecystectomy. This is also commonly done surgical procedure in every hospital and both government as well as private hospital. So this is a cholecystectomy. So what are the indication of cholecystectomy? First of all, indication of cholecystectomy. Hello?
Sir, chronic cholecystitis.
Yes, chronic cholecystitis.
Cholelithiasis.
Okay, this is called chronic calculus cholecystitis. And? So?
Empyema gallbladder, mucosal gallbladder.
Yes, chronic calculus cholecystitis. And then some like empyema gallbladder, mucosal gallbladder, then?
Yes, sir. Prophylactic cholecystectomy can also be done.
prophylactic colchicine, okay. In what condition?
In patients with congenital hemolytic anemia or diabetes.
Diabetes then?
Sir.
Hello.
Sir, 6 weeks after the conservative treatment of acute cholecystitis.
বলো তাহলে একটা হচ্ছে হেড হেমো কি বলে ফর প্রোফাইলটিক কোলসিস্টাইটিস ফর হেরিডিটারি দ্যাট ইজ কল হেরিডিটারি স্পেরোসাইটোসিস পেশেন্ট উইথ ডায়াবেটিস ইফ ইউ গো এবিএম সার্জারি ইফ ইউ ফাউন্ড ইনসিডেন্টাল গলস্টোন ডিজিজ And in some cases, gallbladder polyp, calcification, gallbladder polyp also indication for cholecystectomy to prevent development of calcium of gallbladder. So, common indication are chronic calculus cholecystitis, acute calculus cholecystitis that does not respond to conservative treatment, and mucosal of the gallbladder, empyema gallbladder, porcine gallbladder, gallbladder diverticulum, prophylactic cholecystectomy. So what are the most commonly method of performing cholecystectomy? Most common method of performing cholecystectomy?
Laparoscopic cholecystectomy.
So it is the laparoscopic cholecystectomy. That is the gold standard. Laparoscopic cholecystectomy is the gold standard for gallstone disease. So what are the way of performing laparoscopic cholecystectomy?
The patient must be supine, head up, and right up. Then, sir, we'll give general anesthesia and placement of a NG tube and Foley's catheter.
So, first of all, consent of patient before surgery, anesthetic fitness, and then position under general anesthesia position. It is the reverse cantilever position. Head and right and patient is tilted towards the left. So, how laparoscopic position?
Position ta namta kind of agbe to bolchen.
Reverse cantilever position. Head and raise. And right side is tilted towards the patient is tilted towards the left. So, this is the position. And anesthesia is general anesthesia. Then, how laparoscopy is done? What are the conventional posts for laparoscopy? What are the conventional method of laparoscopy cholecystectomy? Usually, is the four-port technique. So, laparoscopic four-port technique. So, first of all, we go for pneumoperitoneum. There are four ports, 1 to 10 millimeter ports, one for the umbilicus, another in the epigastric ports. Another 2 5 millimeter ports, one in the right subcostal region, another in the anterior G line at the level of umbilicus. So these are the four ports. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So umbilical port for pneumoperitoneum. First of all, we make an umbilical port. Either by open technique or closed technique. And then we introduce the carbon dioxide gas to infect the peritoneal cavity. And then we make another three ports. And then we do cholecystectomy, identify the callus triangle, ligation of the cystic artery, every cystic duct, and then remove the gallbladder from liver bed and then retrieve the specimen. And finally, close the port. Clear? So, pneumoperitoneum is commonly done by carbon dioxide gas. Why not oxygen?
Oxygen will diathermy collapse time.
So, it is there is a burn. Oxygen helps in burning process. So, no need for no use oxygen. What are the other gas used for pneumopneumonia other than carbon dioxide?
Argon, lithium.
Yes, argon, lithium, halogen. But we cannot use this because these are expensive. These are expensive. So commonly use carbon dioxide. It is easily available and it is easily removable to the lungs. It is less toxicity and cost effective. So we chose carbon dioxide. So what are the completion of coal system? What is the possible open coal system? Completion of coal system to me. So what are the completion of coal system to me? Or the possible open coal system to me?
Sir,
again, only
during surgery, after surgery.
So, complication during surgery. So, what is the complication during laparoscopy?
So, bleeding from the cystic artery and from liver bed, sir.
Liver bed, then?
Injury to the common bile duct or hepatic duct.
Common bile duct, hepatic duct, or common hepatic duct.
Injury to the colon, duodenum, or mesentery.
Colon, duodenum, distalis, colon, duodenum. Stomach, even stomach. So there will be injury to the bowel and vessel, like, and also the liver. So there will be injury to the common hepatic duct, right hepatic duct, common bile duct. There will be injury to the stomach, duodenum, liver, even diaphragmatic injury. So these are the complication during surgery. Or During laparoscopy, port placement, there will be injury to the bowel or injury to the vessel. During port placement, port positioning, there will be injury to the bowel and bladder also. So, bladder must be emptied before surgery. This is called bowel bladder must be emptied before surgery. So, usually we cannot go for catheterization, no need for catheterization, but you must be empty the bladder before surgery. No need for catheterization. No need for routine catheterization or even NG tube. Clear?
So bladder
bowel must be empty before laparoscopic cholecystectomy. But no need for catheterization, no need for NG tube. If you just allow the patient to pass the urine and then you transfer your patient to the operating theater. So no need for bowel catheterization and NG tube. If after placement of the trocar, if you find the stomach is distended, in that case, we can go for NG tube placement. So routinely, we cannot go for catheterization and also for NG tube. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So these are the complication of laparoscopic cholecystectomy or open cholecystectomy during surgery. And after surgery, what are the complication?
So infection, then subphrenic abscess.
Yes.
Biliary leakage, biliary fistula formation.
Biliary fistula formation.
And biliary stricture.
Biliary stricture, the late complication. So after surgery, there may be infection. There may be subphrenic abscess, even liver abscess, bile leak. Localized by collection, generalized peritonitis, biliary fistula and late biliary stricture. So what are the causes of biliary stricture following after cholecystectomy?
So instrumentation, for instrumentation, sir.
So either if you if exceed diathermy, or if you like it, the common bile duct, or if you use excess energy source, or you can directly use the bile duct. So there is a late biliary stricture. Either energy source or acidic dissection. So these are the cause of posterior biliary stricture.
Sir, bile leakage during operation hote parena?
হতে পারে হতে পারে ফ্রম দা গলব্লাডার দিয়ে বাইল লিক হতে পারে অর ইফ ইউ ইনজুরড দা কোন বাইল দা দেন হি লিক ইজ ডিউরিং সার্জারি দ্যাট ইজ ইনজুরড ডিউরিং কোন বাইল দা কমন হেবাইট দা রাইট হেবাইট দা ইফ ইউ ইনজুরি ইজ নট রিকগনাইজড ডিউরিং সার্জারি ইফ ইফ ইন দ্যাট কেস বাইল মে নট কাউন্ট আউট বাট দেয়ার ইজ ইফ ইউ নট রিকগনাইজ দা ইনজুরি ডিউরিং সার্জারি সো ইন দ্যাট কেস আফটার সার্জারি বাইল কাম আউট অফ দা ডেন্ট টিউব और पेशेंट में डेवलप बिलियरी पेरिटोनाइटिस ओके सो दीज आर द कॉमन कॉम्प्लिकेशंस सो यू मस्ट कॉशस ड्यूरिंग कोलेक्टिस्टोमी और ओपन लैपरोस्कोपी टेक्निक सो व्हाट आर द मेथड ऑफ व्हाट आर द इंसिशन फॉर ओपन कोलेक्टिस्टोमी
Cocker's incision.
This is the right subcostal Cocker's incision. So, right subcostal Cocker's incision. So, this is called right subcostal Cocker's incision. It is done for open surgery. It is a right subcostal Cocker's incision. It is just a parallel to the costal margin, 1 to 2 finger breadth. Just 1 to 2 finger breadth below the costal margin, from deeper process to the external lateral, at least for 5 to 10 centimeter, even more. So these are the incision for. This is the incision for copper open costectomy, or you can use also transverse incision. Transverse incision. Also, you can use upper transverse incision. So most commonly, it is a cosmetic upper transverse skin field incision. It is a cosmetic incision, and so it is. Though it is a nowadays rarely done. Open cosmetic nowadays rarely done. Only in emergency surgery. In emergency cases, where there is a injury to the callus triangle to avoid such injury, in that case. In some cases, we can go for open cholecystectomy. So, during before laparoscopy, you must counsel the patient. Then, that patient may need open conversion. So, this is the important counseling of patient before surgery. That patient may need conversion cholecystectomy. Clear? So, what are the So here we go for a conversion cholecystectomy during laparoscopy. What are the conditions that may lead to open cholecystectomy or conversion cholecystectomy? What are the conditions? Like during laparoscopy, if you found that there is gross aeration of the gallbladder with the stomach or duodenum. That is called if you see there is cholecystocolic fistula. If you see there is a cholecystocolic or cholecystogastric fistula, in that case, we may need for open conversion cholecystectomy. If you see there is a gross aeration, or if you cannot see the callus triangle, or gallbladder is grossly adherent to the liver bed, a gallbladder is too contracted to remove the gallbladder by laparoscopic cholecystectomy. In that case, we can go for conversion cholecystectomy. So this is the cholecystectomy. The next most important is the inguinal hernia. So what are the incision used for inguinal hernia surgery? Or is the common incision. So this is the carious series incision. So These are the two incisions commonly used for inguinal hernia surgery. On the left side is the transverse skin crease groin incision. On the right side, it is the oblique groin incision. So this is the incision. These are the incision used for inguinal hernia surgery. Yeah, is it clear to you?
Sir.
Bolo. So it is the transverse skin crease incision just above the symphysis pubis or pubic tubercle and extend laterally. It is a transverse skin crease incision. And another is the oblique groin incision starting from the deep ring to the superficial inguinal ring, parallel to the inguinal ligament. Just 2.5 cm above and parallel to the medial tutus of inguinal ligament from deep ring to superficial inguinal ring. So this is the oblique groin incision. Next, what are the steps of hernia surgery? After skin incision, we cut the subcutaneous tissue. Skin and subcutaneous tissue. Then we ligate the. Then there are three important vessel. Superficial three important superficial vessel that must be secured with diathermy. So what are the important three vessels? Superficial vessels. What are the three important superficial vessels during hernia surgery that must be cauterized with diathermy? So these are the superficial circumflex iliac vessels, superficial external pudendal vessels, and superficial epigastric artery. So these are the three important superficial vessels. This must be secured to diathermy. Superficial external pudendal, superficial epigastric, and superficial circumflex iliac vessels. Clear? सुनते बच्चों
जी सर
आफ्टर दैट वी फाउंड द एक्सटर्नल ओब्लिक एपोनीरोसिस द ग्लिसरिंग फाइबर ऑफ एक्सटर्नल ओब्लिक एपोनीरोसिस एंड वी स्प्लिट द वी मेक अ स्मॉल इंसिशन बाय अ ब्लेड डीपी ब्लेड एंड देन स्प्लिट द एक्सटर्नल ओब्लिक एपोनीरोसिस अराउंड द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द इंसिशन एंड देन वी आइडेंटिफाई द हर्निया सेट We put the hernia sac along its core structure. So the most important confirmatory diagnosis of hernia is paraoperative diagnosis. How you confirm that during surgery that hernia is directly in that hernia during surgery? During surgery, you confirm whether it is directly in that hernia. How can you confirm during surgery whether it is directly in that hernia? Bolo.
Siemens test.
Bolo.
So in case of indirect, sir, then on Siemens test, impulse will be shown on the index finger. And in case of direct, sir, Siemens test will show impulse on the middle finger.
So this is the inferior epigastric vessels. This is the relation of the hernia sac to the inferior epigastric vessels. If it is the inner hernia sac lies lateral to the inferior epigastric vessels. If is direct hernia sac lies posterior medial to the medial to the inferior epigastric vessels. So this is the confirmatory test during surgery. Okay. শুনতে পাচ্ছ তোমরা?
জি স্যার।
So if sac lies lateral to the infrapyxic vessel, it is indirect. If lies medial, it is the direct. Okay? So, direct hernia easily lies anterolateral to the spermatic cord. And, sorry, direct hernia lies posterior medial to the spermatic cord. And indirect hernia lies anterolateral to the spermatic cord. So, our next step after opening the inguinal canal, and we can see the how the sac is direct or indirect hernia sac. So after, if you confirm it is indirect hernia, so what is the treatment for indirect hernia? What is basic difference for treatment of hernia, inguinal hernia? Bola bola. Basic difference between a direct and indirect treatment option. What is the treatment option for indirect inguinal hernia? Bola. Ki treatment kori amra indirect hernia te? হ্যালো, শুনতে পাচ্ছ?
জি স্যার।
বলো, ওয়াই ট্রিটমেন্ট ফর ইনডোর হার্নিয়া? তোমার প্রবলেম হচ্ছে না, ওয়াই এর প্রবলেম হচ্ছে, তোমার ব্লক ক্লাস করছো, বলো। ইনডোর হার্নিয়া ট্রিটমেন্ট কি? আর ডাইরেক্ট হার্নিয়া ট্রিটমেন্ট কি, বলো ঝটপট।
স্যার মনে আসছে না।
মনে আসছে না, মনে আসবে কেন? So, treatment for indirect hernia is herniotomy and mesh repair. It is herniotomy and mesh repair. A treatment for direct hernia is only mesh repair. No need for herniotomy in direct inguinal hernia. But in indirect inguinal hernia, you can go for herniotomy and mesh repair. Clear? So, what is the steps of herniotomy? 1. So only direct hernia is a mesh repair. There's someone called hernioplasty. Instead of indirect hernia, there must need for herniotomy and mesh repair. So what is herniotomy? What is herniotomy? So, herniotomy means it is the identification of the hernia sac, then separation of the sac from the cord structure, then separation of the sac from the cord structure up to the neck of the sac, then opening of the sac, then reducing the contents, and finally transfix the sac at its neck. This is called herniotomy. So what are the advantages of the mesh repair? So, hernia repair is commonly done by previous days by anatomical repair, but nowadays we put a mesh to prevent recurrence of the hernia.
To prevent
recurrence of the hernia, mesh is the best treatment for inguinal hernia. So, what are the types of mesh? Commonly we use proline mesh, or Dacron mesh or combined proline and Bickel mesh. So mesh repair. So what are the complications of mesh repair? So there may be infection, there may be seroma formation, there may be mesh displacement, If mesh is infected, what is what you should do? If mesh is infected, so in case of mesh infection, treatment is replacement of the mesh. Clear? Am I clear to you?
Yes, sir.
So mesh is a foreign body, so there are a chance of infection. There may be seroma formation. There may be mesh migration. In case of mesh infection, you must remove the mesh. So now come to the complication of hernia surgery. So what are the complications of hernia surgery? Bolo. What are the complications of hernia surgery?
Sir, during surgery, sir, the important vessel gula cut hoite pare, the injury hoite pare, hemorrhage hoite pare.
Then? What are the other important structure? This must be injured during surgery, other than vessels.
Injury to the vas deferens.
Yes, vas deferens. There is primary core structure. Even injury to cystitis. Then, injury to female, injury to ovary. Injury to large hernia, you may injure the bowel. If continue the bowel, then you may injure the bowel injury. Bladder injury. In case of continuous bladder. So, what are the other important structure that is injured during hernia surgery? What are the contusive inguinal canal? Inguinal canal contents ki male ki female ki bolo, what cord bolo rena mean?
Male hoche spermatic cord. আর ফিমেল হচ্ছে রাউন্ড লিগামেন্ট আর জেনিটো ফিমেল যে ব্রাঞ্চটা ওটা থাকে আর
মেল আর ফিমেল আছে বলো তাহলে এটা হচ্ছে স্পাইনাল কর্ড ফিমেল রাউন্ড লিগামেন্ট এন্ড আদার ইম্পর্টেন্ট স্ট্রাকচার অফ ইনগুইনাল ক্যানাল
ইলিউইনগুইনাল নার্ভ
देयर আর থ্রি ইম্পর্টেন্ট নার্ভ দ্যাট মাস্ট প্রিজার ইলিউইনগুইনাল নার্ভ ইলিউ হাইপোগেসিক নার্ভ এন্ড জেনিটাল ব্রাঞ্চ অফ জেনিটো ফিমেল নার্ভ So these are the three important nerves in the inguinal canal that must be preserved. Clear? So this nerve may be injured. So during surgery, there are bleeding. There may be injured structure like testis, spermatic cord, vas deferens, inguinal nerve, hypoxic nerve, or ligament of ovary. And after surgery. What are the complications after surgery? Bone infection, hematoma formation,
seroma formation.
There may be complications due to spinal anesthesia. There will be spinal headache, irritation of the urine. So before spinal surgery, patient must be adequately hydrated to avoid postoperative hypertension, headache. There may be irritation of the urine. And late complication is the recurrence. Late important complication is the recurrence of the hernia. So to avoid recurrence of hernia, we put a mesh. So nowadays, there are advanced surgical techniques for hernia surgery. Like, it is the laparoscopic surgery. So, conventional open surgery and advanced laparoscopic hernia surgery. Clear? Bujhte pachho, shunte pachho tumra?
Yes, sir.
So, advanced laparoscopic surgery by transabdominal preperitoneal or total extraperitoneal approach. So, nowadays, laparoscopic surgery gaining increased acceptance. Though it is suitable for laparoscopy, suitable for bilateral hernia, for recurrence hernia. For recurrence hernia, for bilateral hernia, laparoscopy is the best option. For recurrent hernia, for bilateral hernia, for direct inguinal hernia, is laparoscopy the best treatment option. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So these are the three important oropharyngeal technique that we have discussed: appendicectomy, cholecystectomy, and hernia surgery. Now some important common abdominal incision. It may also put on OSP exam. What are the common abdominal incision? So look at the skin and see there is a midline incision, there is a pyramidal incision, gyroid incision, lens incision, fenestial incision, upper transverse abdominal incision, subcostal coccal incision, oblique muscle cutting incision. So these are the common midline incision. So what are the advantages of the midline incision? And disadvantage of the midline incision, bolo?
Sir, itar advantage holo eta sir wide space dicche amaderke visual. Then hocche sir emergency operation kora jay. Then hocche.
Yeah, so it is the easy access. So it is the emergency surgery, easy exposure. And it can extend, you can extend the incision easily. And what are the disadvantages
also, sir, scar formation to have bad scar
and chance of hernia. There is called incision hernia. Chance of hernia is more in case of midline incision, but it is the emergency surgery, you can extend the incision easily without any injury to the vessel or muscle. But it's a midline incision. So next is pyramidian. So what is pyramidian incision? It either right or left pyramidian incision. Either above umbilical, below umbilicus. So pyramidian means it is easily 2.5 cm parallel to the midline. So it is 2.5 cm parallel to the midline. It is a pyramidal incision. Advantage, it is good scar. It is a good scar. Less chance of incision hernia. But disadvantage is that you cannot extend the arm easily. And there is chance of bleeding. So this is the medial pyramidal incision. আরে শুনো, এগুলো তোমাদের একটু বেশি রাখবো না ইনসিশন, এগুলো জাস্ট এগুলো আসতে পারে পরীক্ষার সময়। হোয়াট আর কমন অ্যাবডোমিনাল ইনসিশন, ড্র দা উইথ ফিগার উইথ মেনশন দা নেম and advantage and some disadvantage. It may also important for OSP exam. Like tell the name of some, but draw some incision like midline incision, pyramidal incision, gyroid incision, and with some advantage and disadvantage. Question comes in that way. So what are the name some emergency surgical procedure while midline incision is given, bolo.
Sir, acute intestinal obstruction.
Intestinal obstruction, then?
Sir, any kind of traumatic injuries after trauma, sir?
So any form of peritonitis. Any form of peritonitis or any traumatic injury to the abdomen, either arthrogenic, either blunt trauma or penetrating injury, so midline incision is given. In case of if you suspect pneumoperitoneum due to gastrointestinal hollow viscous, commonly we give midline incision. So these are the emergency surgery, like any form of peritonitis, intestinal obstruction, any trauma, blunt or penetrating injury. Even some malignant cases also we put for medial incision. So, what is the surgery for due perfusion? Due perfusion. What type of surgery done for durant the perfusion and gaseous perfusion? Bolo.
Sir, explorative laparotomy followed by the repair the perforation with omental patch. Yes, and yes. Thoroperitoneal toileting.
So, if you suspect, so how can you suspect is the perforation from duodenum? So you see the content. After opening the peritoneal cavity, you see there is a bilious collection around the subhepatic region, and there is gross adhesion. So, see the contents. There is a contents and there is a collection addition of omentum. Omentum is added to the duodenum. So what is the site of, what is the most common site of duodenum perforation?
Sir, anterior wall of the first part of duodenum.
Is the anterior of the first part of the duodenum. So for duodenum perforation, we can go for repair perforation with omental patch followed by thorough surgical toileting. So in the gastric perforation, what additional surgery is done? You have to take biopsy. If you suspect there is a, or if you find a gastric perforation, you must take biopsy. Why?
Sir, chance of the malignancy is more
easily gastric ulcer, easily malignant ulcer. So there is a to exclude malignancy. In that case, we go for biopsy of the edge of the ulcer and flavor of the ulcer. So, in case of ileal perforation, what to do? In case of ileal perforation, what are the treatment options?
Sir, resection, anastomosis, korte pari, sir. Segmental resection, kore, tarpor anastomosis, end-to-end anastomosis, kore dite pari.
Then?
Temporary, mane stoma formation, kore dite pari.
Temporary ileal stoma, korte pari. Then? Simple repair of the perforation. If it is a minimum contamination and if there is a fresh and perforation is a minimum collection, minimum spillage, if the duration is short, patient condition is favorable, you can go for simple repair of the perforation. Repair the perforation. You can go for incision anastomosis with or without stoma. You can simply go for a stoma. So these are the treatment for repair the ileal perforation. For treatment of coronary perforation, the best is for coronary perforation treatment is the
resection anastomosis.
So, if you go for resection anastomosis, especially in the right colon, you must go a proximal stoma. By that time, any type of colon, you can go for a must. If colon is favorable, you can go for resection anastomosis with stoma, proximal stoma. So, must do a stoma, proximal stoma. So depends on several conditions. So you may repair the perforation, you may repair the perforation with proximal stoma, or you can resect the area with an anastomosis with proximal stoma formation. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So I think this is all about today upper surgery. So important topic is the breast surgery. This is not so. What are indication for what is surgery done for breast? Most common breast disease in our country. Most common benign breast disease in our country.
Fibroadenoma.
Okay, it is a fibroadenoma, but it is an inflammatory breast disease, breast abscess. So breast is the most common. So it is an inflammatory breast disease. This is a mastitis or breast abscess, the most common problem in our country. And most common benign is the fibroadenoma. So what is the age of incidence of fibroadenoma? Age of incidence of fibroadenoma?
Young age beshi hoy.
Easily young patient between the 15 to 25 years. 15 to 25 years is young age. So what are the surgical options for fibroadenoma? What are the invasive surgery? So if fibroadenoma is size more than 2 centimeters, you can go for a surgery. Or if patient got symptom, size small but patient symptom, in that case you can go for a surgery. Or the large fibroadenoma, giant fibroadenoma. What do you mean by giant fibroadenoma? What do you mean by giant fibroadenoma?
5 centimeter theke jodi beshi hoy, sir.
If fibroadenoma more than 5 centimeter, it's called giant fibroadenoma. So treatment for fibroadenoma is the enucleation or excision. Enucleation or excision of the excision of biopsy of the fibroadenoma. So what are treatment for breast abscess?
Incision and drainage, followed by the antibiotic.
So initially early stage, you can go for antibiotic. And if there's a response, if patient, if in case cellulitis, you can prefer antibiotic. But if breast abscess develop, we must drain the abscess. So what are the method of drainage of the breast abscess? What are the method of drainage of breast abscess?
Hilton's method.
Bolo. So breast abscess, we may go for drainage of the abscess, or you can go for expulsion of the abscess with or without ultrasonic guided respiration. There is expulsion of the abscess, if small, expulsion of the abscess, you may need rapid re-aspiration also, with or without image guided respiration. Or you may go for direct incision and drainage of the abscess. Incision and drainage of the abscess followed by cavity packed with gauze pack. Packing with gauze, ribbon gauze pack. So this is for breast abscess. So now for carcinoma breast. So what is the treatment for carcinoma breast?
Sir, surgery, chemotherapy, radiotherapy, yeah. Immunotherapy.
So, treatment is the curative surgery and other adjuvant therapy like chemotherapy, hormone therapy, and some palliative treatment by palliative, radiotherapy, chemotherapy, etc. So, what is surgical treatment?
So, it depends on the site.
Bolo, bolo.
Sir, অনেকগুলো অপশন হতে পারে স্যার যেমন স্যার রেডিক্যাল মাস্টেকটমি মডিফাইড রেডিক্যাল মাস্টেকটমি হতে পারে সিম্পল মাস্টেকটমি বা লাম্পেকটমিও করা যেতে পারে স্যার
সো देयर आर टू মেথড অফ ব্রেস্ট সার্জারি নাম্বার 1 ব্রেস্ট কনজারভেটিভ সার্জারি ইফ শি ওয়ান্টস টু প্রিজার্ভ দ্য ব্রেস্ট ইফ ইজ ইট আর্লি ব্রেস্ট ক্যান্সার স্টেজ 1 স্টেজ 2 In that case, you can go for breast conservative surgery. So what are the breast conservative surgery? Breast conservative surgery, what is it?
Sir, lumpectomy, quadrantectomy,
এগুলো আছে
লাম্পেকটমি ইজলি ফর বিনাইন ডিজিজ নো লাম্পেকটমি ফর বিনাইন ডিজিজ ইট ইজ কল ইট ইজ কল ওয়াইড এক্সটেনশন নাম্বার ওয়ান ওয়াইড এক্সটেনশন অফ দা ওয়াইড এক্সটেনশন অফ দা গ্রোথ ওয়াইড এক্সটেনশন উইথ ওয়ান সিডিয়াম মার্জিন দেন সেগমেন্টেকটমি সেগমেন্টেকটমি কোয়াড্রেন্টেকটমি দিজ আর থ্রি অপশন ওয়াইড এক্সটেনশন উইথ ওয়ান সিডিয়াম মার্জিন সেগমেন্টেকটমি এন্ড কোয়াড্রেন্টেকটমি দিস কল কোয়াড কোয়াড্রেন্টেকটমি এক্সিলারি dissection and local radiotherapy. So you must advise local radiotherapy to your chest and axilla after breast conservative surgery. It is must. After breast conservative surgery, radiotherapy must to the chest and axilla. Clear? So this is one option. And another option is a mastectomy. Mastectomy. Nowadays, it is only mastectomy with axillary clearance. Mastectomy with axillary clearance. It may be modified radical mastectomy and radical mastectomy. Now it is only, it is the mastectomy with axillary clearance. What do you mean by mastectomy? Mastectomy means removal of the tumor with all of the breast, including nipple area and skin around the growth. So it is the removal of the growth with skin around the with nipple and areola and skin surrounds the growth is called mastectomy. And axillary clearance means removal of axillary fat, fascia and lymph nodes. Axillary clearance means removal of axillary fat, fascia, and lymph node. But this is mastectomy with axillary clearance. So this is the treatment option for early carcinoma breast. Early carcinoma breast. In case of advanced carcinoma breast, treatment option is difference. You can go for neoadjuvant chemotherapy, downstaging, then surgery. Or you look at advance, you can go for palliative radiotherapy, chemotherapy, hormone therapy, etc. So, this is a carcinoma breast all about